Hello, everybody. My name is Viktor Bogdorov, and I am very much interested in different cleaning because obviously my job is janitory. I like to look at futuristic cleaning. So I found this game called Robot Vacuum Simulator 2013, and I really like the idea of Robot Vacuum. Where we are in Trondheim, it's meant to be future, but we actually use a cleaning device of past. So I want to see this game to simulate this futuristic cleaning so I can see into future with this game. And I want to see how realistic and how futuristic the game will be. So let's click on campaign and we'll start the game. Okay, so here we are in game. I am controlling this big robot vacuum cleaner. And we are going through very detailed room so we can test out the machine and see how well it can clean up different things. So you can see that that room is pretty clean already, but we have some dirt in the middle. So we have these cotton balls. We go to clean the cotton balls. We have to really control the robot. Usually when you play this, when you use the controller for the robot, actually it controls self. But today we are testing it out to actually find the best route. So I am playing for it, but normally when you play in real life, they do it themselves, which isn't an option in the game. I'm pretty sad. I'd like to see that option in the game. One thing is, this is really quick. I've never seen cleaner that move across the room so quick before. So that's actually a really plus point, because normally it takes a long time. Okay, looking at texture of game, because texture is very important to immersion in the game. This game is actually top-notch graphics. I think it is made by Crytek Group, who make the big game Crysis, you know, the really famous game with the really great graphics. You can see that this is completely on par. So I think that this must be made by Crytek Group. You can see all the different wood grain in the floor. That's something you don't normally get with game. In fact, whoa, look at the quality of that wall. You can even see all the lines on the different, on the curtain. I don't know name. Is it called curtain? I'm sorry, English is not my first language, so. I think this, is it a wall? Wallpaper is what it called. I'm sorry, I forgot name. Okay, we go into the cooking room. This is where we'd find housewife, I think. But actually, there's no housewife here, so we don't have to worry about that. Actually, that's probably one bad point about the game. There's no realistic with housewife in kitchen, so that's obviously a problem. Obviously, I can't see vodka on the table as well. That's another big problem. It can fit through the chair gap. That's very good for clean. You can see just right in the top there is the window. Let's try and click up. I just need to pick up that bit of cotton. But now you can see as we move back, this is actually situated in big city. This looks like Tokyo, so that's very interesting. We seem to be in House of Tokyo. That is big Tokyo Tower on the right. I come from Vladivostok, which is very close to Japan, so I go many times as a child, so I know all of Japan. I like the sumo wrestlers and stuff, so. Okay, so we go and we're going to pick up this bit of cotton ball, and then we're going to discover other room. So, looking at other things, we look at the quality of chair. You can see that it's really looks like it's made of good quality pine, so obviously this is sort of wood that I would chop down from tree as a child, so it's very interesting to see how well they managed to recreate that type of wood inside the game. Okay, so here we go. We're going from kitchen, and then we go into the bathroom, because apparently lots of bits of cotton wool always on floor after shower. So this is very realistic. You can see the copying of polygons on the toilet. This is actually very good. I like to see that it's been made so efficiently. That's actually a very good point about game. I like to see efficiency in when they make a game. But it still looks pretty realistic. I'm sure many toilet special futuristic design, they have that sort of lines on toilet. So that's actually pretty cool. Now we're going to see test out the physics of the shower curtain. Actually, this is made in such a way that it actually goes underneath curtain. That's probably a very good selling point about this machine, because you don't have to worry about the physics of different curtain and stuff like that. It just goes straight underneath, you don't have to worry about it. But there we go, we pick up all the different stuff, and this is actually, look at the quality round door. You can see it, it's got a very stylish white border. I like that realism, it's very cool. So that's going to be it. I just wanted to show this game to you, because it's really realistic, and I really like the quality of the game. It's very interesting to me, so I really want to share with everyone, because you really like to see me clean. So I wanted to see another game where I can clean, a special simulator game. So there we go. That is for this video. This is Robot Vacuum Simulator 2013. I will see you next time. Goodbye, everyone. Goodbye.